You know, one of the great things about having a great team around you is that magic happens when you go on holiday. And I've just come back and Fred, our CTO, has completely built an AI assistant that goes into our content brief tool that allows you to have all of the content written for you in a much better way than if you were just going to ChatGPT and saying, hey, please give me 1,000 words on things to do in Hamilton, New Zealand, for example. So what we do, of course, with our content briefs is a much better job of creating structure around the brief, and our AI assistant now can help to write that content. So I can do this for any market. Let's say I'm going for the UK market, and we want the phrase things to do in Hamilton, New Zealand. Okay, and then we go and make the brief. And we're going to let that run for a little bit. I'll pause the video. I'll come back and show you the result. Okay, so the audit is built, and now it's doing some keyword research in the background. The good thing about the keyword research is that that's what is used to help build the content plan, and so you can see the sections of the content plan growing as the number of keywords and the keyword research goes on. So the keyword research here just it was always there, but now we're sort of pulling out new ideas, new concepts. We're using Google Suggest as well as competitor data. We're using our natural language processing algorithm over all of that to find all this information. So the magic was always there to create this content plan in here. But what we've done now is change this content plan, and I'm going to show you what the new system does. So this is now the new system. And instead of having a content plan, what we have is the AI assistant. And now it's generating some stuff. So the keyword research is still going on here. And there's a bunch of keyword variations and all sorts of other things going on. But the AI assistant takes the best of the content plan and then primes you to write absolutely stunning content for SEO. So bear in mind that what we're trying to do is give you really good ideas for things to do in Hamilton, New Zealand. And so we've got our structure here of an introduction, activities we can do, attractions that we can do, events that we can do, food and drink, accommodation, and then some conclusions. Already that's a brilliant structure. And then we've got some other stuff out here that we can have a look at as well. And we've got many other sections if we need them, but I don't think we're going to need that many. I think we're going to get a pretty good article as we go down here. But you don't have to stick to the actual articles. I'll just do a couple first. Let's write the introduction first, briefly introduce Hamilton. So what we're doing here is we're tying OpenAI down to a very narrow dimension because we've already given it the structure that we want. But we have the ability to edit this structure as well. So I'm happy to go with that as my starter. I also want to go for these activities. It's already worked out the activities I need. So it wants to talk about these activities. That's brilliant. And then the attractions, the Wetamo Caves, that's very good. But you know what? I'm going to change this to tourist attractions. Attractions. So we can edit this information here. And what we do if we're going to change this is we're editing the input that goes into the AI. So once I save and update this, this is going to write with a headline of tourist attractions, not attractions. So the content writer is always in control, which I really like. So we're kind of getting these ideas together. All of these are things that we can do in Hamilton, New Zealand. That's brilliant. Input can be modified as we go. Let's go and write a few other things. For example, you know what? The New Zealand Rugby Sevens tournament is brilliant, absolutely great, but you've got to be there at a certain time of year. So I think I'll just take that section out and go without that. And then food and drink. I want to have... I don't want cafes really so much. I want the local restaurants. So you can change things out here. list and change those things out. So as we're going here, we've been writing the content. And let's have a quick look at the content that we've written. So are you planning to travel New Zealand? And are you looking for a unique destination to explore? No, look no further than Hamilton, a vibrant city in the heart of the Waikato region, known for its beautiful parks, stunning gardens, and cultural attractions. I think actually there's also a fair amount of industry going on in Hamilton, but we'll go for the big sell. We've got exciting activities to try, hiking, cycling, water activities. I like all of that. Let's go and start putting these into our editor. So let's just add them in. I don't have to put them in the same order. I can sit there and say, you know what, I want to put the tourist attractions in after my events. So I'll put the events in now, and then put in the editor. You know what, this Hobbiton movie set, this is really good. You should go to that. I've been told about that. But I'm just going to regenerate this and have another try. Let's see if we can improve upon it. Whilst that's happening there, let's go and have a look at some of the other things we've got here. Food and drink, let's add that in there. And let's go down to the conclusions as well. You can see on the right-hand side here, it's telling us which things we've put in, we've analysed, etc. And which things we've put into the system. I'll put in and you can see whether they've been added or not here as well. So I've still got to talk about accommodations and conclusions. You don't have to talk about all of these things, but what is happening over here is that my editor is increasing its score as it's going. I would like to get a score of 80 plus. So I'm going to carry on going down here and just have a look at some hotels. Let's get a few hotels in there. Now, of course, if I was an affiliate, I'd probably want to start putting in my favorite hotels based on commission probably here. Let's also write my conclusion as well. I don't need to talk about the competitors. There's a bunch of other ideas around here that are put in there that you could go and play with and change around. But this is kind of the content plan and the structure, and we've now written the whole lot. I don't have any appendices to put in, so I'm going to leave it at that. So now I've got an editor score of over 90%. And that means that I've talked about these entities with significant impact. So New Zealand, I've mentioned 9 times. Travel, I've talked about 6 times. Experience, tour guide. So you can get a pretty good idea of all these ideas. And we can see what we mean by gardening or gardens, for example. So you can dig into any one of these and see whether that's appropriate. So it's really gardens, I think, that is appropriate here. Wander through the Hamilton Gardens. That's where we've used it. We've got some synonyms in there for those. So you can see a little bit more about the underlying topics. And you can also see, if you wanted to, what topics are semantically close. Now, that was there before, but I don't need to worry about all that now because I'm already at 90%. And if I just modify this a little bit, then I've pretty much got my whole article here. And let's have a quick look at it and see how good it is and how tight it is. And the reason I did this is because Jeannie is heading off to New Zealand next month. So if you want a demo on Pacific Rim time, then book with our knowledge graph manager at inlinks.com/demo. She'll be there on that time. Others will be here on UK time or US time as well. So discover the best things to do in Hamilton, New Zealand. Are you looking? Yes, we've read that. That's good. These are the things that are happening. These are things that actually you can do. Hiking, the 2 different highways, you can walkways you can go along. A couple of cycle routes, so that's brilliant. Some kayaking, and they're really going into the actual details, so that's good. Bungee jumping, that's brilliant. You know what? I don't think Jeannie's going to be bored when she goes to Hamilton. Parks and reserves, zip lining, that's good. Then some events that are in there, we've got those in there. They're all pretty accurate, I'm pretty sure. If I know my stuff, if I know something is wrong, then of course I can edit from here. So you can completely edit this. 120, actually, you know what, it was only 100,000 when it was there, and it was down for COVID, whatever it may be. So you can change this around, and this is a complete editor that you can play around with. But you've got pretty much the whole content mapped out for you, and from there you've got everything you want to make your article. I think that's pretty cool. I think this is a good article, and it took me minutes to make. I like this. I think it's going to be a good tool. I hope you like it too.